Hey guys, welcome back to FedEx Gaming's Redstone Tutorials. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you guys how to build my word combination lock. Now, as you can see right here, we have the entire alphabet here because we have to type in a word for our door to open up. Now, this was actually pretty easy to make for me because I just used my whole 9-button and 4-button combination lock design. It actually made it pretty easy to make one of these. So if you've built one, if you've built my 9-digit combination or my 4-digit combination, it's gonna be pretty simple for you guys. However, if you're still only basic to Redstone, I highly recommend not building this. I highly recommend just like sticking to my simple designs and things like that until you've become better with Redstone, because I know people are going to be in the comment section below asking things and I'm just probably never going to answer you because I know this is hard, and if you're doing something you cannot truly do, then you shouldn't be doing it. Like I said, you need to understand outputs, inputs, and all that good stuff. So pretty much my word is Redstone. So I have to type in Redstone. If I put any word in, if I put any letter in the wrong way, it won't work. If I put in the wrong letter, it won't. If I put in the wrong letter, it won't work. All that good stuff, yada, 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 so on and so forth. I also have a nice little reset button over there just in case I feel like I need to reset the whole thing. So we have to pretty much just type in Redstone. So R, E, D, S, T, and where's O? Oh, that, wait, there it is. O, N, E. And my door opens up over here after I typed in Redstone. We go inside. We got some guards in here that are going to pop up. Get out of the floor, guard. Hey. Where's his face? Okay. I didn't say he had a face. So we come into our secret room, and we can actually close the door behind us if we want to. Boop. And then we go inside our secret box, and this is where we keep the launch codes and cookies. Don't ask me why we have launch codes and cookies in here, but I'm not gonna grab them, whatever. So we just click the button, we leave our secret area where our launch codes and our cookies are, closes up behind us, and we go off into our merry little way. Now, like I said, if we click any one of these letters in the wrong way, so if I put, let's say I put in R, E, D, and then I put in, let's say an H, okay, I put an H in. And now let's put S-T-O-N-E in. So like S-T-O-N-E. As you can see, it did not open up because I put in the wrong letter. Also, if we put in the letters in a different order, it won't work also. So if I put, let's say S-T-O-N-E. And then we're gonna put in red. So R, E, and D. And as you see, the door did not open up. So you don't just have to click them in different orders. You have to literally put the word in the right way, and you have to use the right letters or it will not work, guys. So like I said, pretty difficult build if you're pretty new to Redstone, but it's whatever. We're 3 minutes into this video, so let's just start building this thing. I just wanted to show you how everything works in it and all that good stuff. So let's just start building this thing, guys. All right, guys, so I'm not going to be giving a definite spacing for this build, and I'm not going to be giving the amount of resources you're going to need for this build because it is a big build. You should obviously, if you're doing this on survival, you should obviously be pretty far in the game and have enough resources to build this. Now, it's not really that many resources except for the repeaters. There is a lot of repeaters for this. So let's just start building this thing, guys. So what we're going to need is a 13x3. So we're going to pretty much just go down 13 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And we're going to do that 2 more times. So now, of course, my block of choice I'm going to be using is quartz right now. You can use whatever you'd like. There is nothing that will burn in this build. So you can use wood or whatever you want. So once you got your 13x3, we're going to take our buttons out, and we're literally just going to put 13 buttons on the bottom and 13 buttons on the top. So 13 buttons on the bottom, 13 buttons on the top. Now, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to speed up the video here because I'm going to put in all the little letters. And well, actually, I'm just going to cut the video out and then come right back. I'm just going to put in all the letters, you know, A through Z, the alphabet. Hopefully, you guys know the alphabet. And I'll be right back. And then if you want to pause the video and do it the way I did it, then that's absolutely fine. So I'm going to cut the video out here. All right, guys, and there you have it. I put all the letters in for the alphabet. So if you want to pause the video right here and put them in as well, instead of having to do it yourself, you can go ahead and go right ahead and do that right now. I'm going to be starting to do all the redstone stuff and all that good stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and start doing redstone. So where all our little buttons are for our A through Z, we're going to come to the backhand side, and we're going to put redstone torches on the back of every single block that has a button. So pretty much it's just the top row and the bottom row. Just put a row of torches, and then put a row of torches up here as well. Now, let you guys give you, I'm giving you guys a heads up now. Most of these torches are going to get deleted. Now for your build, when you're putting your word in for your combination, you can only make it up to 15 letters long. You cannot do more than 15 letters. I'm sorry, that's how mine works. So it has to be at least 15 letters long. And also, like I said, most of these torches are gonna delete because we don't need any of the torches that don't have the letters in them. It's like, so let's say I'm doing redstone. I don't need a Q, do I? No. So that's gonna actually be my word. I'm gonna be using redstone like I did over here. Now that's where it gets difficult too. This is where this build gets difficult for people that are not savvy with redstone or are actually over basic knowledge of redstone, is you're gonna have to think of your own word, and every word's gonna be different. My word is definitely not gonna have the same exact look like this as yours is, especially if it's longer and all that good stuff. So that's where it's gonna get difficult. However, we're not up to that part just yet. So what we're gonna do is now come back here and we're gonna delete underneath our block right here, our bottom blocks for these buttons. We're gonna delete under that one block like that. So just do that all the way down. So just delete right underneath it, one block. And then I want you to take out your redstone dust and bring that all the way down along the whole entire bottom, like that. Some of these are gonna get deleted as well. That's when we're actually picking out our letters though. So mine is gonna be redstone. So I'm gonna need R-E-D-S-T-O-N-E, of course. So obviously if you know your alphabet and you don't have to come up here and look for the front, cause you know, you can remember that this side's A, so it's A, B, C, D. Hopefully you know your alphabet. So the first half of the alphabet, A through M, is gonna be the top. And then the bottom half of the alphabet's gonna be N through Z. So that's all you gotta really remember. So if you're gonna build the exact same word as I am, redstone, then this build's gonna be super easy for you. If you're gonna have to think up your own word, it's gonna get tough. Trust me, it's gonna get hard. I know it is, but hopefully you are good with redstone. If you are not that good with redstone, then I highly recommend you stop building this right now. So we're gonna need, so the top 13 is A through M. So the only two letters I'm gonna need at the top for redstone is E and D, because E and D is the only ones that are in the top 13. So A, B, C, D, and E right here. D and E is the ones I want. So you're just gonna put a block right here and right here. So figure out what letters are in your word and then just put blocks in front of them just to remember which ones they are. That's the only reason I put these blocks here, is to remember which one's which. So I don't need any of these ones right here. So I could delete all of these torches now. Since all I need is D and E, all I have to do now is just delete all these torches because I'm never gonna need them. There's no point in using things you're never gonna need. Now we're gonna have to go at the bottom. The bottom has a lot of them, you know, like the bottom has N, O, S, T, R, you know, all the ones I need. So N is right here, so it's easy, N through Z. So N, so I'm gonna need N for redstone, so I'm gonna put a block here. But before I do that, I want you to delete this block right here, delete down a block, and then put redstone dust like that. Now this is only if you have that letter. I'm using N, so I have to do that. So I have to put now a block here like that, just to remember where it is. And I'm gonna be using O as well, so I'm gonna delete this one down right here and put redstone like that. And I'm gonna put a block here, so N-O-P-Q-R, I'm gonna be using R. So I'm gonna delete this one right here, delete down a block and put redstone, and then put a block right here. R-S, I'm gonna be using S as well, so I'm gonna delete this redstone, delete down a block, put redstone down here, and a block here, and I'm gonna be using T as well, so I'm gonna get rid of those two. Put redstone dust and then a block here, and that's all the letters I'm going to need in my build for redstone. I don't need any more of these letters, so I can go ahead and delete all of these torches now. I don't need any of these, so let me just delete these real quick. Now like I said, you obviously are probably going to be doing a different word. You're gonna have to figure out which ones you're going to need as well. Now this is the part where it gets difficult, because this is where everyone's is going to be different. Now you can have as much space as you want, you know, you don't have to make it as small as mine, you don't have to make it as big as mine. Just I'm just giving you a heads up now. Any number, any letters used at the bottom is gonna be the easiest way to do it. Any letters you use at the bottom are gonna be easy. Any letters at the top, this is what's gonna make it hard. But I know it's hard to not choose letters at the top because, you know, there's three vowels at the top. There's A, E, and I up here. You know, it's kind of hard to, because most words have an A, an E, or an I in it. A lot of them do. So I know it's gonna be hard not to choose certain words at the top. But if you could try to stick away from it, it will make it 100 times easier. It just does. Because right down here, all you have to do is with any of these bottom ones right here, all you have to do is just put repeaters coming out of them. So just put repeaters at the bottom coming out of your torches like this. That's why I said it's so much easier to do the bottom ones, because that's it. You only have to put repeaters at the bottom. But for the top ones, now the top ones, this is where it gets a little bit difficult. Now, if you're doing the same exact word as me, if you're doing the same exact word, redstone, as I am, all you're literally gonna have to do is for redstone is just for this top part right here for, I believe this is D right here. Yep, that is a D. So what we're gonna do is just come off down the side right here, put some redstone dust here, come down another block, put redstone dust here with a repeater like this. Actually, I did that wrong. Never mind. Don't do that. What you want to do is come down underneath it like this, put redstone dust, and then put a repeater like this. That's what I did for there. Okay, that's going to be D right there. And now right here, now you don't have to make it all nice and even as well. I mean, you could have it come out over here if you really want to. You could skip a block or something like that. But for me, I just kept it nice and even. So if you're doing redstone, all you're going to have to do is just come out a block right here like this. Put redstone dust here. Put a block coming out to the right-hand side with a repeater going this way on one tick delay. Put a block in front of the one tick, and then come down a block and put redstone dust here like this. And then we're gonna have to come out one more row of repeaters on every single one like that. And that will be the whole entire setup for redstone. All right, guys, this is FedEx from the future. Actually, it's not really the future. I completely forgot to tell you guys this one little big detail, and I feel really stupid about it. When you're building your word, make sure you do not go past the left-hand side. As you can see where A and N is, make sure you do not go any further with your actual word. You can go as far as you want to the right with your word. So if you like, say your word is supercalifragilisticexpialidocious and it went all the way over to here, you're able to do that. Make sure you do not extend past the left-hand side right here. Make sure it's always flush like that. All right, guys, that's all I wanted to say. All right, bye. All right, guys, so now we got redstone spelled out. Now, like I said, this is the hardest part of the build right here. This little part right here is the hardest part because you have to figure out how you're going to set up your own word. Now, I got redstone here. I don't want you guys to get too, like, you know, confused or something like that. So, like, every single repeater doesn't need to be right next to each other. I mean, you can have them spread out a little bit, but like I said, the bottom ones are going to be the easiest ones. The top ones are going to be the hardest one. So, like, let's say if I had like a few more torches like this, and then you just have to bring the power down to here. That's all you have to do. Just bring the power down. Now, the main thing is you just have to remember that you can't have them connecting to each other. So, if I wanted to put redstone dust here to bring the power down to here, I could not put another piece of redstone dust like this, because now you have both of these letters connected to each other. If I did this, then both H and I would be connected to each other, which we cannot have. That's why I said if you built my combination locks and stuff like that, you'll have a better understanding of this. You'll understand that you cannot have letters be interacting with each other. See how these two do not interact with each other? Because that repeater stops it from touching this torch right here. Makes it come down so it does not interact with any other letter. So once you get your whole letters in, once you get all your letters like perfectly in your redstone, you just got to remember where which ones are too. So the top ones, like I said, are hard. The bottom ones are easy because they're always going to be in the same place. The top ones are going to be hard because they're going to be moving around the repeater. So over here where, you know, where P and C is, that's actually where my D is going to be, actually where my E is going to be. So this is going to be E right here. This one's E and that one is D. D is actually in the same spot, which isn't that hard to remember. But E, I had to switch over to here. So it's gonna get a little confusing. I know it is, but hopefully you understand how this is all working. If you don't, then like I said, you should have never watched this video. Next, what we're gonna do is just pretty much spell out our word. So my word's 7 letters long, so it's pretty simple to remember. So we're gonna dig down 2 in front of these repeaters. If you're doing redstone, then this makes this a lot easier on me. So we're just gonna spell out redstone. So dig down 2, so this is gonna be R. So R, E, D, S, T, O, N, and E. So that's redstone right there. So mine should be 7 blocks long. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ooh, did I go over one? R-E-D-S-T-O-N-E. Oh, mine's 8 long, huh? Okay. So I forgot, whatever. Okay, so mine's 8 long. So it's R-E-D-S-T-O-N-E, redstone, beautiful. So next what we're gonna do is if you watch like my 9-digit combination lock and my 4-digit combination lock, it's gonna be the same exact thing, guys. Exactly, same exact thing. Actually, let me get rid of these redstone torches. Those are gonna annoy me. There we go. So pretty much what we're gonna have to do is spell it from the back. We're not gonna be spelling it this way. We're gonna be spelling it backwards towards the repeaters over here. So like I said, it's pretty easy to remember as long as you remember your alphabet. So if I come back here, that bottom one right there is going to be N, O, and then right there, since it's up there at the top, that one's going to be my E, D, and then this one's going to be R, S, T. That's just the alphabet. So right here's the R, so mine's going to be redstone, so that one's the R, so right here's where my R is going to go. So put a block up here with redstone dust, and then my E is going to be right there. That one's my E, so I'm going to come back over here. We're going to skip down one, And this one's gonna be my E, put my redstone dust here. If you don't understand, like if you can't figure it out doing that way, then of course you can always come back over here, you know, look over here for your letter, look to see where it's coming from, and then come back over here and put it down. That's the only way I could say you could do it, but hopefully you just remember your alphabet. So my D is gonna be right here, that's my D. So there's R, E, and then D is gonna be right here. So that's red, and then I'm gonna put stone in. So that one's R, S, so there's my S. So this box can go right here for S, red stone, so T, S, T, and then O is gonna be all the way over here. That's my O right there, C, N, O, so O, red stone, and this is gonna be my N, and then I'm gonna put another E in for redstone. So my E is right here, I'm gonna follow it down to here, and there's my E. And that will spell out redstone. So R, E, D, S, T, O, N, and back to another E. Very easy to do, guys. All you, like I said, if you can't figure that out, then you can always come back to the front, look at the letters, then swing back onto the back side, and then do it the same way. But like I said, it's the same exact thing with my combination lock. Once you get a hang of it, then you know it's pretty simple to do. Next, what we're gonna do is just bring our redstone down towards our right. So we're just gonna go like this and bring it to the right. Like I said, exactly the same thing as the combination lock. Just bring it all the way down to the right with every single one. And we're actually gonna delete out more over here. But first, we're just gonna bring all our redstone to the right. Just keep bringing it all the way to the right for every single block, like that. And then what we're gonna do is dig down two more in two more spots. So one, two, one, two on each one. So one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Just do it all the way down, every single letter. Remember, do not make it more than 15, guys. It has to be only 15. Only 15 this way. It could be more than 15 if you have the same exact letters, actually. I lied to you. So if you have let's say there's four E's in the word, then I guess you can make it longer than 15, but then it has to have four E's in the word. Then we're just gonna bring the dust out one more. Like I said, this build pretty much, the more you get used to building it, the easier it becomes. It's not a difficult build, but it can be difficult for people that are basic to redstone. Next, what we're gonna do is just put a block up in front of every single piece of redstone dust here. Like that. Then we're gonna put a torch on every block. Same exact thing as my combination lock. If you built my combination lock, then you should have no problem building this. Is the sun going down? No, it's not. It's okay, we're good. We're good. Then on top of every one of these blocks, we're going to put another block right above the redstone. So just put a block above every single piece of redstone, like that. And then I highly recommend using a different color here. I'm going to go ahead and use, let's go with green. So I'm going to use green here, and we're going to just bring it out now above every single block so we cover up all these holes right here. So just bring it across every single one. The only one we're not going to put in above is the redstone torch. Just put it above every single block, like that. And then in front of every single repeater, so just go like this. There we go. Just make sure it's in front of every single one of your repeaters. Now, like I said, the repeaters don't have to be right next to each other. They do not have to be right next to each other. I just did that to keep it nice and, like, you know, nice and confined. But like I said, if you want to just make it as easy as possible for yourself, the bottom letters are the easiest ones to go with. So let's say if I had another letter here, then I could put a repeater over here. You know, these two spots can be open. They don't have to all be right next to each other. That's just to keep it as compact as possible, all right? Just giving you a little heads up, you don't have to do that. Then on every single block, except for the different colored blocks we kept for our redstone, see, that's R-E-D-S-T-O-N-E, redstone. We're going to put torches above every block except the ones that are above our redstone. See how I put a different color? That's why I put a different color block there, guys, so you can remember where that redstone block is. So do not put a torch on top of any block that has redstone underneath it. So the torch is gonna go across every green block except for those orange ones. If you're doing the word redstone right now, it's gonna make this thing 1,000 times easier for you to build. I highly recommend actually maybe going with redstone at first, because like I said, it's a hard build, it really is. It's not too hard, but if you're not that into redstone right now, then it's gonna be hard. And then what we're gonna do is literally just put a repeater in between every single spot, just like the combination locks. Put a repeater between every single block. Like that. Almost there. If you know how to build your my combination lock, then you actually don't even have to watch this video right now, because literally, like I said, it's gonna be the same exact thing pretty much. So now, it's not gonna be the same exact thing. We got our reset switches down here, which I'm gonna get to. Actually, I forgot to put the reset switches in for the top here, but we don't have to worry about that right now. Next, what we're gonna do is take out another block. This is gonna be for our reset, this in case we get it wrong. So we're gonna put blocks above every single torch, that. If you want to, you can also put a block down here as well if you really feel like doing it. You don't have to do it, but just to make it like, I don't know. If you have an OC problem like me, maybe you want every block to just be nice and filled in. So put blocks above every single torch. Like that. Almost there. I would just speed this up, but I'm not going to do it because, like I said, this is a pretty difficult build. There's nothing really to it, though. It's not a super difficult, but like I said, if you're not really into redstone as much, then I highly recommend not building it. So once you got all these blocks above every single redstone, take out your redstone dust and just bring a line of redstone dust above every single block. This is going to be for our reset in case we put in the wrong letters. This is only the reset for if you put redstone in the wrong way. If you put like I said, if you put stone red in, it won't work because this will reset it right here. If you put every other letter in, this is what's going to reset it over here if you put in the wrong letters. All right, guys, so I know we were working on the reset, but we're going to head over to the actual word combination itself. Now, the reason why I want to do this is we can always come back to the reset. I'm just going to do this so you guys know that your word is actually working inside your combination. So we're going to get rid of the blue wool for now. We're going to take out yellow wool for our actual combination word, and we're going to take out our pistons and our sand blocks. So I want you to come back over here to where we had our torches that are facing up off every block. We're going to put our pistons facing upwards off every single one of these torches right here. So just go ahead and put a piston right above every single torch. So if your letter's longer, I mean, of course, you're gonna have to go further out and all that stuff. If yours is shorter, then you can make it shorter. It doesn't really matter. It's always gonna be looking the same. It's the same looking thing all the time. Doesn't really matter. Next, what you're gonna do is put sand right above each piston. And then we're gonna take blocks and put blocks in between every single sand block. Then all the way out here in the back, we're gonna come out another block. We're gonna put a repeater here. Then we're gonna come down a block, put a torch right here with a block on top of the torch. That will make this repeater come on right here. And then we're gonna put repeaters going in between every single block, going back towards the front. So we're just gonna put a repeater in between every block. Like I said, if you did the, I know I said it a lot, but if you have done the combination, then this will make this part 1,000 times easier for you because you already understand how to do this. And then we're gonna put redstone dust over here at the end of this block. Now we're gonna go ahead and test out to make sure our thing's actually working. So I'm gonna go ahead and type in redstone. So if I hit the R, when I hit the R, that sand block in the back should pop up. So if I hit the R, that sand block popped up. See how it popped up? And then if I hit the E, the next one should pop up. So R, E, D, S, where, oh, S is over here. S, T, and then O, N, and then last but not least, E. So if yours did not go up like that, if it didn't go up one at a time, all the way down the line, then you did something wrong, and I'm sorry, but you're gonna have to go back, and if you fully can't understand it, then you're just gonna have to stop the build. I'm sorry, but like I said, it's a pretty tough build if you're not really used to redstone. So what we're gonna do now is, if yours worked out completely fine, if every single block went up one at a time, all the way down the line, then what I want you to do is come to the back, delete this torch, and then just put it back, because yours is working absolutely fine. You don't have to go fix anything, because if as long as it's doing that, then it's working absolutely fine. It's doing exactly what it needs to do. Also, when you hit E, if you have two letters in your word and you see another one pop up at the same time, that's just because E is on the same line. Like, see how this one pops up over here and that one pops up over there? Don't worry about that. It's supposed to do that. That's if you have maybe three letters in one word or maybe four of the same. It's supposed to do that, trust me. So once we got our whole redstone thing and working, now we can go ahead and actually work on our reset switch. So we want to have it reset in case we put in the wrong, if we put in the wrong letters, and we also want it to reset in case we put in the word the wrong way. Like if you put an E in front of the R, like eraser to stone or whatever, you know. So we're going to go ahead and back, we're going to go ahead back and take out our blue wool. That's what we want. And we're going to come down on this side, on the left-hand side, we're going to come down a block. Like I said, just like the combination lock, you're just going to come down a block. So if you've done the combination lock, then you should have an understanding of how this works. I'm gonna keep bringing up that combination lock thing. It's just, if you want to, I highly recommend doing that before building this, because it'll make understanding how to build this a load easier. Next, what you want to do is, next to every single piece of redstone dust on top of this block, we're gonna put another piston facing upwards off the block and put sand on top of each block. And then we're gonna do the same thing like we did over there. We're gonna put blocks in between every single one of these sand blocks. So I'm gonna go ahead and take out my yellow wool again. We don't need our blue wool anymore. That's a whole reset right there. So we're just gonna put blocks in between every sand block. And then we're gonna come off the back two more blocks, put a repeater going this way, and a piece of redstone dust behind it. and then put repeaters in between every block going towards the back. So repeater, 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 I put that one on the sand block by accident. Repeater, 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 like that. And then we can put redstone dust here. And then on the back over here, we're gonna come down underneath the block right here and put a torch here. That will activate this repeater over here. Next, coming out of the block with the torch, we're gonna put a repeater going this way on one tick delay, and then just bring a line of redstone dust down to over here. That's to reset it in case we put in the wrong combination. Then coming out of the block with the redstone torch on it, we're gonna put two repeaters like this. It should go, one should go underneath this piston and put them both on four ticks delay. Put a piece of redstone dust next to the block, block up from the redstone dust, and then put a repeater going into this block on one tick delay. Next, what I want you to do is take out your redstone dust and then just literally bring it all the way down to over here, to the last piston right here. And then we're actually gonna delete this one right here and put a, you know what, let's just leave it. We're gonna come back to this. Just leave it like this. We'll come back to it. I don't wanna get too confusing. So up here at the top, all we're literally gonna do is just bring the block down from here, bring it down one more time, and then just connect it. See, that makes it a lot easier to remember. All you have to do is make like a nice little spiral staircase all the way down, and then actually delete this one and put a redstone repeater here, like that. Next, what we're gonna do is actually have to set up this dust right here to connect to over here. So all I did was, all you're gonna have to do is just put a block up next to your redstone dust like that. Put a torch on top of it. This is actually part of the reset. I should make this part blue, but I'm just gonna, I'm gonna make it blue. Okay, this is actually part of the reset switch, so I'm actually gonna make it blue here. So put a block up next to it. Like I said before, put a torch on top of it. Block on top of the torch, like that. And then we're gonna bring it all the way down till we're one away from that top dust right here. See how it's one away from it? And we're gonna put a torch right here, which should activate that dust. And then we're gonna bring a line of redstone dust down all the way these blocks. So bring it all the way down, like that, beautiful. So then when we actually put the combination in and we get it right, it resets everything. Cause you want it to always reset itself after you put in the combination. You don't want it to get stuck in there and not keep it, cause then it's gonna stay up forever and you won't be able to reset it. So you want it to actually reset itself. So now if we put in our combination the right way, again, I'll do it one more time, R. See how a bunch of blocks went up on that side? That's in case we put the words in the wrong way. If we put the letters in the wrong way, then that's what happens. This will, a bunch of these blocks will stay up, thus breaking the build. So R, E, D, so red, S, T, O, N, ooh, N's over here, N. And then when I put E in, it should reset everything. So let me, where is it? There it is. E, and it should reset everything. See how everything reset right there? That's due to this right here. It goes over to the actual reset switch, which will bring power all the way around over here, thus turning off this torch and resetting everything. So that's how that works right there. Now we want to set it up so any of these top blocks right here, because the bottom ones, we're actually, you know what? I'm getting ahead of myself. We're gonna just set up the reset for every other button. So if we put in, let's say, since mine's redstone, if we put a B in, we want it to reset everything. So what you're gonna do is right above these numbers, buttons right here, we're gonna put a bunch of redstone like this over the whole entire thing. Just put redstone all the way down the whole thing. And then right where the torches are, wherever you kept your letters for the top, we're gonna delete these redstones right above these torches. And then always, always, the power for the reset switch always goes towards the left from the front. So we're gonna put repeaters going towards the left right here. So boop, boop, like that. That's just so if we put in a number over here, it will reset everything when we get over to here. So now we're gonna put in our reset button. So we already put the dust down under here. Remember when we did this at the beginning where we put the dust underneath our buttons over here? There should be a line of dust going down over here, except for the buttons that we're actually using. It should look like that down there. We're pretty much just gonna connect our dust up here and our dust down here to our middle reset button. So all I'm gonna do is just gonna skip one block from the original. So take out your blocks of choice and just make it 3x3 like this. I guess you really don't have to do this. It just makes it look nice. And then I put my reset button right here in the middle like that. So it should look something like this. There should be a gap in the middle right here. Then on the inside over here, we're gonna do the bottom one first right here. We're gonna do this bottom one first. So what you're gonna literally do is just put a torch coming off this block in front of it, like that. So we're gonna put a torch coming off this block right here. Is that how I did it? No, that's not how I did it. Never mind, don't do that. We're gonna put a torch literally coming right off the block itself right here. So make sure you always come out one more. Yours might not come down over here. Like I said, if whatever your word is, it might not come down here. Yours might actually be like this, but it doesn't really matter. So if yours is literally like that, then you actually don't have to put any dust on top of this block right here. You're going to put a torch coming off this block right here. put a piece of dust going this way out of the torch, delete this block, and put another torch right here. Put a block above the torch, and put redstone dust here. So like if I click the button right here, it resets it. But now if I put in the wrong letter, let's say if I click P, it also resets it. See that? It's kind of hard for me to do it. Let's just put a button right here. So this is where P is right here. So if I click this, it will also reset it as well. Next, we're going to come out from this block right here and put a repeater going this way on one tick delay. So now if we click any button down here that is not the right letter to our build, like if I click P, it will reset everything. And I'll get to that once we actually get it fully in. Next, what I want you to do is now all we have to do is bring this dust down to over here. So all we're going to put it do is put a block right in front of this dust, put a torch, put redstone on top of this block right here, and then put a torch right here. And now if we click any button up here, it will reset it as well. All right, guys, so we are completely done. We have put the resets in for all our buttons. Now that's it. So all we have to do is, like, let's say if I put in red, so R, E, D. As you can see, those three blocks came up. And now let's say I click L over here, it will reset everything. See, boop. And I'll do it one more time for the bottom rows as well. So R, E, D, and then if I click W over here, it resets everything. So now all we literally have to do is just put A input for R, whatever you want. I was gonna say something, but I was like, it really depends what you want. I know a lot of people are having confusions with like JEB doors and all that stuff, and 3x3 piston doors, and just piston doors in general with the combination locks. So I wanna give you guys a little heads up about that. If you don't know what monostable circuits do, and you don't know what pulse extenders do, then you shouldn't be building this. Now, I know some of you do have redstones, your redstones have, you know what you're doing, but some of you still don't quite understand that yet. So you shouldn't build this build if you have no idea how this stuff works. So I'm gonna build a quick JEB door, right? I'm gonna build a quick JEB door, give you a heads up on how stuff works and all that good stuff. And then we're gonna, you can go ahead and do whatever you would like. So we're gonna ahead and go build ourselves a quick JEB door. So right off this block right here, this is gonna be our output block for our build, but it technically goes into the inputs. The output to the input to what we want to open up. So what we're going to do is put a monostable circuit coming out of this piece of dust right here. So we're going to put a piston facing upwards, a piece of sand here, a block coming out of that piston with a repeater on one tick delay. That creates a monostable circuit. That creates a half a tick pulse, which if we go ahead and put a sticky piston or certain things in front of it, it will let go of blocks and all good stuff, creating a T flip up and all so on and so forth. And I'm not going to get into that because it's just going to make the build even longer. So right when we got our monostable circuit here, I'm just going to go ahead over here and build a JEB door. Now, if you have a M or a Z in your letter, then you're going to have to bring your JEB door out at least three blocks. So one, two, three, and your JEB door is going to end up like right about here. You're going to want to bring it out at least three blocks like that. One, two, three, because you don't want your M or Z getting in the way of the JEB door. So we're going to pretty much just build a nice little wall like this. Then delete the four blocks we put in. Make sure it comes out three from the wall. So one, two, three, and then this is where your door is going to be. And we're going to build a quick JEB door. I'm not going to go crazy about it, guys. I'm just going to build a quick JEB door. I'm not going to show you how to do it. Hopefully many of you know how to build a JEB door already, so you don't have to go insane with building this thing. Let's go ahead and build a quick JEB door. We're going to put our blocks of choice in front of them. Blocks of choice above it, like that. Like I said, I'm not going to be going like, oh, put redstone here, redstone there. This is not about a JEB door. We already did the build. We are completely done with the build. This is just pretty much extra. This is pretty much just an extra. So four ticks, two ticks, four ticks, two ticks. Put some dust in front of that. Come down a block. Put some redstone dust here. Now you could go ahead and put a lamp or powered rails here. I prefer power rails, but if that your power rails don't work, then you're going to have to use redstone lamps. So I'm going to put some powered rails there. Some dust here. Down block, dust, and powered rails. Actually, see, I didn't come out enough. So if yours is going to the M or the Z, as you can see, I didn't come out enough right there. So it would actually break it. See, it would actually break it there. So you're going to have to come out one more. So come out at least four blocks if you're doing it. But mine, it doesn't go to the M or the Z, so I don't have to worry about all that stuff. Next, what I'm going to do is pretty much just bring the power for my monostable circuit up to here for a sticky piston. So I'm just going to put a block right here. Right here. Then we're going to put a torch off this block. That will activate our JEB door. Put redstone dust here. Then we're going to come out another... I did that wrong. Never mind. Come out. We're going to put a block here. put a torch here, put redstone dust on top of it. I'm gonna put a block here so it doesn't connect to each other and do that whole wigging out motion it just did. Put a block right here next to that redstone dust with a torch here. Come out another block, sticky piston on this block facing the torch, block on top of the torch. Now all we have to do is bring power from this repeater up to this sticky piston. So just bring power up to it like this, like that, and then put dust here. So now if I put in my code, our RGB door should open up. So redstone, so R, E, D, S, T, O, N, E. Our jet door opens up and we can go ahead inside our secret little room. Now we have to make it so it closes on the inside. Now that's a pretty easy thing to do as well. All we need to do is make a pulse extender. Very, very easy to build a pulse extender. All we have to do is come out from, I'm gonna come out from the top of this dust right here. And we're gonna put a repeater here on one tick delay. And then we're just gonna bring a bunch of blocks out like this. Put redstone down all these blocks. We're not gonna probably go this far, but I'm just gonna do it real quick. We're gonna put a block up next to the redstone. Pretty much just go like this all the way down. Make a nice little pulse extender setup like that. So it should look something like this. Then we're gonna put four tick delay repeaters going into each block like so. And then a one tick delay repeater going into that dust. And that will create our pulse extender right there. Then we're gonna come a block underneath it with redstone dust like this. Put some redstone dust here. And then just create a line going down towards your JEB door over here. So we can get the button a little bit closer to our JEB door. Put some redstone dust along this whole entire thing. Come out one more from here. Redstone. And then our button's gonna go right here. So this is where my button's gonna go. So now if I click it over here, it should close the door. Oop, why didn't that... Oh, did I actually... Oh, a repeater has to go into this block right here. So put a repeater going into that block. That should close the door. Closes the door, and then when we're ready to leave, we click the button, opens the door, walk on out, and closes it behind us. Very easy. Pulse extender, JEB door, monostable circuit, T flip flop. Hopefully, if you're building this thing, you have an understanding of how all this stuff works. But there you guys go. That's how you build the entire build. It is that, well, not that, I shouldn't say easy. It's actually really hard to do. But hopefully you guys don't get mixed up with, like I said, the words and all that stuff and the letters. Pretty much that's the hardest part, is just dragging out your actual word itself, like bringing the letters over to make a nice little layout for your thing. But like I said, it doesn't have to be right next to it like this. You can bring it out a little bit further if it has to go out further. I just kept mine nice and compact like that because I could. But anywho, that is the entire build. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave it a like and subscribe to stay tuned with my newest videos. All right, guys, peace.